Well, a very good afternoon to you. It's Sunday the 8th of January 2016, just coming up to 5 o'clock in the afternoon. If you're watching us live, it's just coming up to 5 o'clock in the afternoon on the date I just mentioned. If it's another time, then you're watching a recording of the show. But it doesn't matter, you are all very welcome. Let's say hello to the early people who are already with us this evening and awaiting a moment of fun and frivolity this afternoon. Just a minute, I've got my thing ready. There we are. Hello to Shania. Shania, he has asked me to wait half an hour to start today's show because apparently her and her dad I don't like to tell people's secrets, but they're a dirty old pub again, aren't they? Her and her dad are down the old pub again. Now, I did suggest to Shania, I think it might be her dad Vectis, they've just done a radio show this afternoon. Vectis and Shania, they do a radio show on Sunday afternoons. I don't know when else they're on. Do you do a show during the week at all, sort of evening time or anything like that? I'm not sure about that. Anyway, they've just done one this afternoon and they wanted me to wait half an hour so that they could get home and watch the show. I mean, God's sake, man. I mean, is that what you're like when you get, if you go on holiday? You know, if you've not quite made it to the plane. Oh, hello. Oh, hello, is that British Airways? Yes. Yeah, do you mind waiting half an hour? We haven't finished our breakfast yet. No, we can't wait half an hour. Are you serious, dear? We've got to start. Millions of people all over the world are waiting for the show to start. We can't hold it up half an hour just because you're going to finish the old drink in the pub there, my old mate. You know, you can't wait to have another drink in the pub, can you? Can't you take it home? Ask them to put it in a plastic glass for you. They might allow you to carry it home there. Dear me. I'm teetotal me, you know. I hope when I come to the Isle of Wight, you don't start pulling me round pubs. Unless, of course, you've got fans waiting for me to meet. Yes. I mean, I don't mind that. That happened to me when I went up to see my nephew. My two nephews, my niece and my sister, up to North. And great nephews and great nieces. Oh, you have to be so careful you don't miss anything out. Perish the thought if I was to put one set of children up here and not the other one. That's why there's none up here in case I make a mistake. Oh my God, you'd never really enter. Why aren't my kids on the wall? You'd never really enter. That's why there's none here. They're all down. I've actually got two pictures up here. Do you want to see my pictures up here? One moment, please. There we are. Look at that. That's George and Emily. I think they might have been cooking. I don't know how I'm guessing that. That's George and Emily there. These are old photos. I've got new photos. Oh, dear me. Oh, dear. I did say that I wasn't interested in cleaning, wasn't I? So that's that one. And here are... That's my niece's two children. And there's another one on the way. And there's another bun in the oven. How exciting. Another small person for me to play with when I go up there. If we don't play with the adults, they're boring. God, they're boring. My sister and her husband and now my niece and my nephew and his wife, they're sitting there watching EastEnders. Coronation Street. Emmerdale Farm. I'm on the floor with the children playing with wooden train sets and things like that. So much more exciting, dear. And playing TikTok. Do you know what TikTok is? Do you know what TikTok is? I did tell you at Christmas, or are you a new viewer? If you're a new viewer, a very warm welcome to you, new viewer, or two, or three. Yes, TikTok is where... You get the said child. Now, they can't be too old or too big to do this, OK? They have to be a certain size. But TikTok is where you get them to lay on the floor, on their side. They put one hand up and one leg like that, right? And then you pick up the hand and leg as the adult and you swing them. Tick-tock, tick-tock. And they get higher and higher until they are touching the ceiling. Only to have my sister turn around and be horrified in case one would suddenly fly through the window. But the children don't see that, and neither do I. We want to have fun. We don't want to sit there. Oh, I wonder what's going to happen in Coronation Street today. Oh, who's going to die today? Who's going to have a row today? Who's going to be caught sleeping with someone else today? Oh, for God, so how boring is that? I mean, I would watch Coronation Street in EastEnders. They haven't even got spaceships in them. There's not even spaceships in these programmes. You've got to have a spaceship in a programme or a film for me to be interested. Either that or something like James Bond. And all the red comes down, doesn't it? Yes. So there's the picture of the children. Here's the other two. I beg your pardon, the other three. This is Olivia, who I told you about yesterday. She's the very severely disabled, this little one. And she's having an extension built on the side of her house at the moment for all her special bed and all her equipment that she has. All right. That's Evie. And that is Harry, okay? Harry is naughty. Harry is naughty. And he's the one that that really started the game TikTok. He says, Chris, TikTok, Chris, TikTok. And then he lays on the floor like that. Oh, I can't wait to tell them these things at their weddings. I really can't. And don't you worry, I will save those videos for their weddings and show them on some sort of screen somewhere. And talking of screens, we go all the way back. You see how I'm linking stories together? Very professional, dear. Very professional. Why this phone here has not rung with someone from the BBC? Oh, no, dear. No, they prefer to spend millions of pounds on things like Frozen. You know, just a one-off film. Frozen. How much did that cost them on Christmas Day? Frozen. Millions, dear. Millions. Whereas I'm available for just a few £1,000 per show. I mean, it's not bad, is it? I'm so much more value. And I can sing all the songs. Let it go, let it go. Let it go, let it go, let it go. Let it go, let it go. Let it go, let it go, let it go. I think there are more words to that one, but I'm not sure. Yes, so here we are linking right back to what Vectis said about screens. Okay, Vectis and Shania, there must be screens in the pub, dear. Link into one of the computers and you can have my show beaming around that pub, entertaining the three or four customers that are sitting there. Yes, I like the idea of that. You go into a lot of pubs, don't you, Vectis? Let's be honest. Or is it just the one that you go in? Here, I must tell you, my mate runs a pub. Now, I cannot reveal what this pub is, okay? Because that will identify the person. But get this. So he has this DJ working there. Not me, I hasten to add. Definitely not me. He has a DJ working there regularly. Has done for years. In fact, this particular DJ took over the job that I didn't want to do anymore, okay? And I didn't want to do it anymore simply because, and you'll probably laugh at, you're probably, oh, don't be so silly, Chris. The person concerned, the manager concerned, got two new dogs. And they were okay at puppies. But as they grew up, whenever they saw me, they would go mad. That, as in angry mad, you know, woo, 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 woo. And I was scared of them. I was terrified of these two dogs and I wouldn't go in a pub anymore after that. And he's like, don't be silly, they won't hurt you. And they all say that, don't they? They all say that. The dogs, this dog, you know, you've got this dog standing in front of you. Oh no, he's okay. He won't hurt you. What a load of old rubbish that is, dear. I was terrified of these dogs, so I didn't go back anymore. And I'd been working at this place for years. Honestly, that is the honest truth. So he had to find somewhere else. This is a few years ago now. So he found someone else and he's been there for a few years now. Anyway, for New Year's Eve, okay, so New Year's Eve, the night's going on. At 2 minutes to midnight, 2 minutes to midnight, the DJ goes up to the manager and says, have you got the bells? And I'm like, what do you mean, have I got the bells? Well, have you got the bells? I know they're on a CD somewhere in my box, but I can't find them. Have you got them? So there were no bells. And Auld Lang Syne. He found Auld Lang Syne, but he couldn't find the bells. Can you believe that? How can you be doing a job New Year's Eve as any sort of entertainer, DJ, cabaret artist, singer? How can you be doing a job on New Year's Eve going through the midnight period and not have your own set of bells? Everyone needs them, dear. Ding dong, ding dong, dong, ding dong, ding, followed by Auld Lang Syne. I've got a wonderful version of Auld Lang Syne I use. Oh, yes. It's very, very orchestral and full of singers and instruments. We've got a call coming in. Good evening. Who is calling on line 17?
Hello, Chris. It's Kevin from Worthing.
Hello, Kevin from Worthing. Good evening. How are you?
Fine, thanks.
Worthing. That's a nice old place. There. I quite like it.
Well,
there.
I'm actually from the east end of London and... I just moved down here. I didn't like it at first, but I love it now.
Oh, really? Why did you move from the east? What part of the east?
I met someone, and he asked me to move down, and took it from there, sort of thing.
Oh, that's lovely.
Yeah, I could never live back in London. There's too much on the go for me.
Now, it's funny you should say that. There was a bloke. actually, let me try and bring up his. He's not a viewer. That's the only thing. So. I think it was one of the London DJs, Pete. Let's have a look. I'm sure it was him. It's funny you should say. Here we go. Yes, I found it. And he put exactly the same thing on his Facebook yesterday. And it basically said, used to love London, but now I see London as not the place to be.
Really?
Oh, yeah. And loads of people put comments. I used to love it. Prefer Belfast now. It has changed and not for the best. Where do you want to go then? I'd love to live in New York. Oh, no, not New York. So many people there. How old are you, Kevin?
I am 49.
49. So do you like it a little bit quieter now?
I do, yeah. I've done all like, the pubs and the clubs and that long while ago, and it gets a bit boring after a while, I think.
We all have, haven't we, Kevin?
Yeah. I like watching your show and the karaoke. One of these days, I'm going to come to it one of these days.
Yeah, come along and sing us a song. That'd be nice, Kev.
Yeah, I watch a lot of your friends and that on your show, and they look a great crowd.
Oh, they're lovely people. Characters,
especially Mary, makes me laugh.
We like the term characters. You want a bit of a character, and that's it. You know,
life is too short for miserable asses and all that sort of thing.
Oh God, yeah. What would you sing if you came down, or would you just come and watch?
Oh, it'd have to be probably a George Michael number, Dusty or something, you know?
What, George Michael?
Anyone from George Michael. I'm a big fan of him.
Yeah, I'd quite like to have a go at the Careless Whisper one, but the range of notes is quite large, and I don't know if I, you know, I might not get that low or that high.
I would have to have a little bit of a drink first. I'd be too nervous.
Yeah, would you, actually, let me try something. What George Michael one would you do?
I like Cowboys and Angels, is one of my favourites.
Angels?
Cowboys and Angels.
Cowboys and Angels. Oh, I don't know if I know that one.
It's one of them off the Listen Without Prejudice album.
Right, okay, I haven't got that one. What else would you try?
What else?
Do you like any of the Wham stuff?
Oh, I love it. Wake Me Up Before You Go-Go, yeah.
Wake Me Up, really? Do you know the words?
So-so, yeah.
Right. Go on then, try it out. Here we go. Go on, you ready? Can you hear that?
Hear the bug. Hear the bug.
Here we go.
You put the boom boom into my heart. You make it so sad. I can barely hear it.
Oh, yeah, it will... Yeah, it does come out as a bit quiet, I'm afraid. Let me just stop that.
My best friend told me what he did last night.
Good effort, Kevin. Very good effort. Is there many places to go out down there in Worthing? Just...
No, the gay scene. We had one gay pub and that didn't do very well. To go any gay sort of scene and all that sort of stuff, you've got to go Brighton, really.
Yeah, I'm not keen.
Worthing's too laid back. A lot of elderly people and all that sort of stuff.
I'm not keen on Brighton. What about just a general pub? Is there any of those?
Oh, yeah.
There, which are quite nice.
Have you heard of Arundel?
Arundel. Yes, I was on the radio there. Yeah, it wasn't on FM. It was an internet station called Play Radio.
I don't know.
And this is a number of years ago now. Yeah. And it was in the weirdest place. You'd kind of come off this main road going to Brighton, possibly the A23?
That's right.
Right, OK. You'd come off this main road.
Yeah.
You'd have to... excuse me. You'd have to turn right off this main road, which means you went across a very, very busy road. And it was a bit dicey. I don't know why. I mean, you know, they would have been better. They'd be better to put a roundabout there, I suppose. But so you had to turn right.
Roundabout's a nuisance, isn't it?
Well, you know, you'd have to turn right across this really busy road,
yeah.
And then you went down this little country lane for miles and miles, and through these fields, and then suddenly, in the middle of these fields, was this big building, and it was the radio station, Play Radio, and there was some other stuff in there as well. I think some sort of satellite repair company or something like that. And that's where it was. Yeah. Yeah, Arundel, that was.
I noticed you say that you like doing karaoke more than DJing. Why is that interesting?
It's much more fun. You get more involved with people.
Yeah.
You do.
I suppose DJing is late hours, isn't it? Sort of.
Well, I mean, karaoke can be late hours. It's not really the hours. It's just... I got very bored with a lot of the DJ, and I don't like a lot of the music now. Mm. Certainly the really heavy R&B. Well, now, there's R&B and there's R&B, you know. I mean...
I agree with you there. Some of them that you can't understand what they're singing.
Exactly.
About.
Now, two good examples from the same singer. Beyoncé, Crazy in Love, that's great. Drunk in Love, horrendous. Horrendous song, that, Drunk in Love. And but the young people really like it, so it was time. You have to know when to come out.
I see your Barry Manilow fan. I love him.
Looks like we made it.
Have you heard him singing with Barbra Streisand?
I have, yes. Although
I'll tell you what, I love Streisand. She's one of my favourites and all.
Not on stage, though. Have you been to any of his shows?
I haven't, but I would love to see him.
Oh, my word. Well, he said he wasn't doing any more, but we think he'll come back at some point. You must, you know, no disrespect to anyone, but you must go next time he's here, because I don't think you're going to have much more of a chance.
I wish I went and saw him when he come over here. Obviously, I ain't got a passport abroad, so...
Oh, right. Well, he's getting a little bit old on his feet, you know, and you can see sometimes he's struggling, because he's got a new hip, and you know, you can only do it so long, and then you've got to take it easy, really.
Mm.
Did you say you haven't got a passport?
Oh, then I don't really bother, really, you know.
Well, no, he comes over here.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I would see him here, but you know, I'll see him when he comes over here, but not over in America.
No. Well, yeah, I'm sure he'll come over here in another couple of years or sooner, hopefully.
So the recordings of the shows that you've done come out really well.
Oh, you've seen those, have you? Good.
Yeah, they were brilliant.
Good.
With your friend Ronnie, he's a bit of a looker, isn't he?
Oh, please, give it a rest, will you? Whenever I go out...
I've watched one of your shows, you and Ronnie, and the way Harry puts you down, how do you take all that?
Oh, well, I just slap him. I mean, obviously, you don't see that on the show. But once I switch...
You know, he says about your phone and all. I thought,
oh,
how could
dreadful.
You have a friend like that and he puts you down? In the
well, it's dreadful. What I do is, once the show's finished and I turn the camera off...
Yeah.
And I then... What I do then is pull the handbrake. If we're in the car, I pull that... I get him to pull over. I just stop over there a moment and he stops... Right? And then I go around to his side, I drag him out of the car, throw him to the ground and kick the hell out of him. That's what I do. And then if I've got any sort of cans of drink or tea, I get that out of the car, pour it over him. Yeah. I pour it over him and then I drive off and leave him there. That's how I deal with that.
But
so don't you worry.
Your car before he takes you.
Eh?
I thought he takes you, that's not your car.
No, he does take me most of the time. He's usually the one who's driving, yes. If I'm driving, you don't get a show, obviously, unless I get him to hold the camera. But, you know, he's a bit disappointed because my car's bigger than his now. I mean, he may have a BMW, but I've got a little RAV4 Toyota. Those Japanese make wonderful cars, you know.
At the end of the day, they all do the same. He's a bit of a boaster, isn't he?
Oh, yeah. You know, when I start talking about things and what have you. For example, yesterday I said, oh, they've been waiting for me at the bank because I've got no money to lend people.
Right.
Well, you know, that's all a bit of a send-up. Most of what I do here, most of our little chats, it's all a lot. There's a lot of truth, but a lot of it's a send-up as well. It's all about having a bit of a laugh. Well, that's what we want to do, because there's too much...
You have a laugh, ain't you? Laughing would be too miserable otherwise.
There's too much seriousness in this world. That's what I think, Kevin. Yes, indeed. Did you?
Yeah, I'm sure I've not known you personally, but I think when I used to be go on the club scene, you used to do a lot of DJing a long while ago, didn't you?
That's right. Yeah, I was all over the place. Yeah.
Yeah. Is that pub going? Do you remember one called the Penny Farthing?
Oh my word! Yes, in Hammersmith.
Yeah.
Yes.
Because the pubs I used to go were the Black Cat. Yeah. Shame that's gone now.
That's gone.
And,
very sad.
The Swan.
Yep.
Benji's Nightclub on a Sunday.
Yep. No, the White Swan is still there.
Yeah, but it's really been revamped, hasn't it?
Oh, it's been completely modernised in there. And they're open. They asked me to DJ there, and I said, well, what time is it till? 5 o'clock, I don't think so. And they're always surprised. Why not? Well, because I don't want to work till bloody 5 o'clock. Well, what time do you want to work till? 1 o'clock at the latest. We can't be staying up till all hours,
I'll
dear.
I tell you what, you have got a great sense of humour, mate. I watch you every day, and you know, sort of when I'm feeling down, you really lift my spirit. Sort of
well,
thing,
Kevin,
you know?
You've got to have a sense of humour with a face like this. Let's be honest. I've more got a face for radio than television, dear. That's what I have, love.
You ought to do some more of these calling things. They're good.
Well, actually, this week I've done quite a lot. You may have noticed this is like the fourth one this week.
Oh, is
but
it?
It's only because
don't overdo it, dear.
It's only because I've had time off. Funnily enough, let me let you into this secret. Now, I never muck up with work. I never, ever muck up with work, right? And I'm sure I haven't. Oh, I haven't got it here now. I'm sure I haven't. But last night, when I finished the show last night, which was quite late. I think it was about 11 o'clock, 11:30, something like that. We did a late night one last night.
Yeah, I'm up late normally.
Was you up last night? Anyway, so I went downstairs and I thought, well, I'll put the telly on. And I did say I was going to go for a walk last night when I'd finished, but I didn't go for a walk. One of the other things I sometimes do to keep exercising going is walk on the spot in the living room. And I put the telly on. And actually, it's a good way to do it, because if you're watching something on the telly, and walk it. And when I say walking, I don't mean, you know, you've got to go, you know, as you're walking along and swing your arms. When you're watching a telly, suddenly you've done 25 minutes walking fast and you haven't realised the time going.
Right.
So that's good. Anyway, so I turned the phone on and suddenly it bleeped. And it was my agent, Kelly Wilde. You know Kelly? Gloria.
Yeah, do you remember a pub a long while ago called the Bull and Pump?
No.
They used to call it La Mirage, I think, Shoreditch.
No, I don't know that one.
Oh, Kelly used to go in there, and I said to her one day, is that your hair? And then I could, down the line sort of thing.
Oh, no, don't say that to her about her hair. She's very, very, very protective over that hair, you know.
Oh.
Very
well,
protective.
I could tell now that it wasn't. It was a wig.
It's not a wig, dear. I'm sure it's not a wig.
Nah, she's lovely. She's nice anyway.
Perhaps I could have a wig. I don't know. Anyway, so she rung up and she says, and it was a message. It was actually, it wasn't a phone call. It was a message that she'd left at about 10 o'clock. Yes. Hello, darling. Where are you? Are you here? Well, no. You're supposed to be at Central Station tonight. Anyway, I looked at my diary and there was no mention of it.
Right.
Because I do every Monday there, every Friday, and every other Saturday. Well, I've just been there, New Year's Eve. So this is the next one. So generally, I'm not there. And she says that the other DJ who does the other night swapped some dates around or something. And I she's sure she told me, but I would have written that down. So I'm sure I haven't mucked up.
What do you mean in the way she's your agent or?
Well, she put me in that particular... It's the only place I work for her. She put me in that particular venue. So, therefore, I have to pay a small commission for that. It's about 10%, which is... That's fine. That's okay. And she said I was supposed to be there last night, but I haven't got that written in my diary. And it doesn't fall on the next week, you know, on, off, on, off, on, off. So this was an off week, and I haven't got anything extra written in there.
Yeah.
However, at the end of the night, at the end of the month, I've got two offs. So I think she's told me the offs, but she didn't tell me the extra on.
That's
and that's
good,
what's gone wrong there. So I don't think I have mucked up. So I was a bit surprised. But I think it was all sorted in the end, and someone filled in and was able to operate the sound and the lights.
Is it a fairly big pub, that Central Station, then?
Medium size. It's not massive. No, I wouldn't say it was massive. In fact, no, I would go small to medium. Upstairs is small to medium. But there is a pool table at the back.
Yeah.
And like the stage and that is at the front, and there's a bit in the middle and all that. Yeah, yeah.
Right.
Quite a nice place. Very friendly in there. Certainly on the karaoke
nights.
Oh, anyway.
When you got that platinum disc and it made you emotional.
Barry Manilow.
You made me feel a bit emotional.
He's touched this. Barry Manilow has touched this, dear. He's touched it. Touched that piece of paper that I've got hanging on my wall there. Look. That is as close as I'll probably ever get to Barry. I do hope that someday he might be watching one of these shows, you know, on his little 25-inch television screen in his living room. And he might call up and say, why don't you come over? I can't do an American accent, really. Why don't you come over to Palm Springs and do a little show with me there? Oh, wouldn't that be fab if we could do a live show with Barry Manilow, international megastar? Oh, I'd love that, Kevin.
Who else have you seen?
Elton John.
Any good?
Yes, very good. Liza Minnelli, very good. Wham, I went to see Wham, but that was years and years and years ago.
Yeah.
That's about it when it comes to pop stars and that sort of thing.
What do you think about this George Michael thing? Do you think that he's ever had something to do with it?
I don't know. I don't know. It just seems a bit odd. Didn't he sleep in the car or something on that
night?
That's
what I mean. Well, why would he sleep in the car in a way?
Well, because he didn't want to be in the same house as him if they'd had a row. You know? That's what I think. Anyway, have you been to see anyone in concert?
I've seen Erasure, Michael Bublé.
Oh, Michael Bublé, yes, yes.
Hugh and Cry, yeah. At the Worthing Assembly. We've got the Worthing Pier and the Worthing Assembly Hall.
What's that? They're the
different place. The Assembly Hall is where you get all the concerts, and the Pavilion is on the pier where you get pantomimes.
They're the music venues, are they?
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
All right, Kevin. Well, thanks very much for calling in. Lovely to speak to you down there in Worthing, my friend. All right.
And you keep look after yourself. Keep well and look after yourself.
I do. See you, Kevin.
See you then. Bye.
Thanks for calling. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Oh, lovely. Kevin calling in there, boys and girls. Let's just... Kevin... Was it Worthing? You're in Worthing, aren't you? I do put people's names on the old Skype so I can remember them next time they call in. All right? The phone number's up there if you want to call in at all. 020-8144-3477. If you've got Skype, you can Skype in. My Skype username is, all one word, United Kingdom Talk. Or you can use the Facebook call-in thing as well now, I think. Yeah, you can use that, all right? We haven't read these little messages coming up there, so let's say hello to people who are with us today. As I say, Shania's with us. Are we on the screens in the pub yet, Shania? Come on, chop chop, dear. Danny Davis, Rod Brown, Jerry's with us today. Hello, Jerry. Oh, Jerry's got problems with his legs. He's got legs covered in little bites, haven't you, dear? Or spots or something. Now, have you got a pet? That's the thing. You might have... Don't start thinking you're dirty, because I had this problem years and years ago and it is easily sorted. You might have got fleas from a pet into your carpet, and it will only get worse unless you take action, Joey. I must warn you of that. I had that problem years ago. I went out and bought these two cans. You have to go to the vet. You must go to the vet for these things. Don't be buying something from the supermarket. Useless. Absolutely useless. You go to the vet. You say, I think I've got fleas in my carpet. They give you this big can of spray. Not cheap. I think when I bought it, it was 16 quid, this thing. And you spray it all around the room, you know, psst, up in the air, around the carpet and in the corners. Okay? Quite a lot of it. You then close all the doors and leave the house. Leave the house for a few hours. Come back and you'll see, when you come back and open the door, you'll see all these dead insects everywhere. You've got to do the whole house. not just where you got the bites, because the fleas will travel, okay? I'm not saying you have got fleas, but if you have, you must treat that, my darling. Otherwise, it will get worse and worse and worse. Get on top of that problem now, my darling. Hello to Matt Martins in Canada. Kevin, I think those are you I just spoke to there, wasn't it, Kevin? All right, hello, Kevin. John Childs with us. Matt Taylor, hello, Matt. Oh, on permanent holiday. Matt is always going on holiday. He works for the railways. Hello, Matt. Hope you're well, sir. Always on holiday. When's your next holiday, Matt? Kiara Torme. Hello to Kiara. Zach's with us. Tony Power. Kiki D. Stacey's there. Claire. John says, I had to tear myself away from watching the football to watch this instead. Oh, I'm so pleased. You can't be watching all those little men. Oh, it's something very strange about football. I'm sorry, dear. There really is all them men running around in them tiny little shorts and sharing a bath together. Something very, very wrong there, dear. Very strange people. Hello to Tom Harris, to Paul Gallagher as well. Oh, Matt's going to call in. Hello, Matt. How are you?
Hello, I'm good, thank you.
Matt Taylor. Now, when's the last time I spoke to your little voice, sir?
A long, long time ago.
I know. Years ago. Now, I keep an eye on certain people. You're one of them. You're one of them. And
right.
I spot that you seem to be on a little bit of a permanent holiday, Matt.
I know. Literally, when I come to work, I go, oh, you're coming to work for a break then, have you?
Do you go to the same place all the time? Or you?
No. So I'm going away end of this month, a couple of weeks' time, believe it or not. I'm going to Tenerife and Lanzarote for 2 weeks, so...
Oh, Tenerife. I've got a friend who works there. I don't know if you know him. The Boy George Experience.
No.
Keith George? Okay, he goes around all the clubs, all types, hotels and clubs, and he does acts and things like that. He keeps telling me that I should go out there and I'd get work out there and all that. I'm kind of quite happy here in the UK. Would you like to live anywhere else, Matt?
Probably somewhere in the Canaries, I'd imagine.
Would you? What, Grand Canaria?
Yeah. Maybe. I've been out there 3 times this year.
God. You're not hanging around that old shopping centre there all day long, are you?
The Yambo.
I went, I think, 4 years in a row, and I'm sure I started to damage myself after that, so I stopped going.
Oh, did you? You went to
the amount of
alcohol you drink, isn't it?
Do what?
The amount of alcohol you drink, yeah, it's damaged you.
Oh, my word, yeah. But that's all it is. It's so popular, that place, and all it is an old shopping centre full
exactly.
of bars. Gosh.
Yeah, that's it.
Now, did you say you went 4 times last year?
Three times.
Gosh. And have you got a favourite hotel that you go to or just different? Whichever.
Yeah. I walk in. I don't even have to give my name. They take my passport. They always take my government passport and just let me in. Give me a key. There's your room.
They already know you?
Yeah.
Which one is that?
It's by right next to the Yambo. So is it Las Vacarias?
Gosh, you're right on top of it, aren't you?
Yeah.
Blimey. Now, when I went, we went... excuse me a minute. Let me just have a good cough. Cough isn't as bad as it sounds, actually, all right? You kind of came out of the Yumbo Centre and you would turn up the stairs and then, you know, where that burger place is, up the stairs, and you come out and turn right...
Yeah.
Go up to the top and turn left and then turn right. And then you kind of went down this really steep hill which went round to the left.
Oh, yeah.
You know where I am?
Yeah.
Okay.
Back of the golf course.
That's it, yeah. So walk a little bit down there and that's where I stayed a couple of times. And it was a nice little resort. Correct. All one level
yeah.
and a little pool. And it was nice there. It was nice. And there was a little path. There was a little path that went to my room, Matt. And all I'm saying is that the other people that were on that holiday who kind of met, you know, while I was there, you know, they had other rooms and mine one was right at the end. That little path, for some reason, became known as the Walk of Shame. Now, I don't know why that is.
No, I wonder.
Oh, no, I won't even go there.
Okay. Did it have revolving doors?
Had revolving doors, yes.
Okay.
Have you been at that one?
No.
Oh, okay. What's the furthest you've been?
What, on holiday?
Yeah.
Thailand.
Now, I haven't even been there.
I've been twice now. I went last year.
Wow. And you like it there?
I like it, yeah. Absolutely love it. Love it out there. I want to go back again. So,
what parts did you go to, Matt?
Well, the first time I went in 2006, I went to Bangkok and Phuket. This time around, I went to Chiang Mai, Bangkok and Phuket.
But Bangkok, it's just full of people. You're a people, but you like loads of people everywhere, don't you?
Yeah, I do, yeah.
Yeah, see, that would do my head in, that would. Oh, and yeah. Plus, I wouldn't be able to eat anything, Matt.
Really?
Oh, no. Insects on sticks and cats and things like that.
I've avoided all that.
Oh, yeah, I bet you do. Do you like a little scorpion on one of those sticks? Surrounded,
yeah, I've seen them.
Surrounded seen them. By that amber stuff.
No, I wouldn't eat anything off street vendors out in Thailand.
Oh, really?
You're accustomed to it, yeah. You're probably going to make yourself ill, so...
Do you think so? Have you tried it before, or have you known
people? No, I wasn't going to risk it, so...
So what do you eat when you're there?
Any Thai food would be fine, but I'm careful where I eat out there.
In restaurants, yeah?
The conditions aren't 100% over, are they, so...
Do you go with people or on your own?
Yeah, a big group of six of us went last year.
Okay.
So the year before, I think four of us, so...
And when you're going to not Torremolinos, where did you say again? You're just about to go there.
Going to Tenerife.
Tenerife. Are you going there with people?
Yeah, again, one of my mates just on the way. So, and I literally have just come back to Torremolinos, didn't I? Back in November.
Lovely, lovely. You'll have a nice time there. You always seem to make friends wherever you go, don't you?
Exactly. Yeah. So.
Yeah. Yeah. Are you still driving trains? You used to drive a train, didn't you?
No. I'm operation control now.
Okay. What's it like?
That for 2.5 years.
What's it like driving a train?
Interesting.
Is it boring?
It's like driving your car, really, but with like driving your car, you haven't got a map, you haven't got a sat nav, you've got to know inside out everything.
Right.
So driving trains easy. It's the underpinning knowledge that's the issue and what you've got to know.
Why did you stop doing that?
It's a long story, but I come off in the end, so...
Okay.
That's the end of it, to be honest.
You're happy in the office now, aren't you?
Yeah, I'm happy doing that now, so...
Good. Have you been to any concerts? We were just talking to Kevin about concerts and things.
The last concert I really went to, I don't know if you class it as a concert, was... The X Factor final in Lambie Stadium a few years ago.
Oh, okay.
Louis Daniels was in. That was involved still.
Was that full up, was it?
Yeah. Yeah.
Wow.
It was a good few years ago, wasn't it? So.
Did you see the programme last night, Let It Shine?
No, I was working last night in the doors.
Ah, with Gary Barlow. I thought it was really good. Yeah, really good. And then I've just watched only about 10 minutes of the new series of The Voice, which is now on ITV.
I caught a glimpse of that last night.
I thought that was good. My favourite person on there is Will I Am. I think he's fantastic.
Yeah, he is. Yeah,
I think it's absolutely fantastic. But they've changed it slightly. So if someone sings and no one turns around, right when it's finished, when it's finished, they just walk off. They don't turn around and say why they haven't chosen them. And that's kind of missing a little bit out for me, really. I quite liked it when they turned around, because they were never nasty on there. Not like the X Factor, when they can be nasty to them, can't they?
Yeah, there's no Simon Cowell on there with some choice words. But...
Oh, I think you've got a little bit of a crush for Simon Cowell, to be honest, Matthew.
Oh, no. Oh,
I can see it in your eyes. I'm looking at your picture now. I can see it in your eyes.
No,
whereabouts are you? Down in Bristol?
I live in Bristol now. I've been here just over four years.
Yeah, you like it down there, don't you?
Yeah, I love it down here. So.
Nightlife and all that. How old are you now then? 28?
And a bit more, 30.
Are you 30 now? Blimey.
Yeah.
Oh, well, how the time flies, doesn't it?
Yeah. The last time I saw you was 2009? Was it Oxford working?
It was. I was working in...
Cloud Nine
in Oxford, DJing, and come to see you in the train station, didn't I, where you were working?
Yeah,
that's right, yeah.
Yeah.
Gosh, so long ago. The only other time I've been to Oxford since then is to go to that Bicester Village. Bicester Village, is it Bicester Village? Oh, I love it there. that's a day's outing, that is. And funnily enough, I will be going there for my birthday.
Okay.
me and my mate, when we have our birthdays around that date, we have either Chris's day or Ronnie's day, and I get to choose. We get to choose where we want to go, and it's usually Bicester Village. Or did you say Bicester? Bicester or Bicester? Bicester, is it?
Bicester.
We go to. I've got a Bicester Village or London. Now, if you go to London, you've got all that hassle getting there, the parking, so many people. So we go to Bicester Village, and that's a whole day, and we walk around, and he buys me something. And usually, you know, once I'm there, the bloody credit card's out, and it, oh, dear me.
Oh, okay, yeah.
So you I quite like that.
Sound like the Americans there, Chris, calling it Bicester.
Is it Bicester Village? Bicester.
That's what they say, yeah.
Oh, you would get that on the trains when you used to, when you was a boy. And you started on the trains. Were you the one on, like, on the platform saying, yes, you've got to go there, you've got to go there and all that? Did you do that?
Yeah, that's it, yeah.
What's that called? Dispatcher?
Platform dispatch.
Dispatch. So you would have had people, Americans, coming up to you and asking, for example, the Tate Gallery.
A what?
Tate Gallery. Well, I'll tell you where this is coming from. I used to work on directory inquiries. That was one of my first jobs when I was 18 years old. And the Americans, bless their hearts, sometimes they see the words differently. The Tate Gallery is the Tate Gallery.
Oh, okay.
Tate Gallery. But they would call it the Tate Gallery and things like that. And they would abbreviate things. Have you got the number for the VRS? Go on, have a guess. VRS.
Absolutely no idea.
Victoria Railway Station.
Oh.
And I'd say, well, why didn't you say that? What? You don't know what the VRS is and you call yourself an Englishman?
Really?
Oh, they're wonderful. I love America. I absolutely love America.
And the Chinese and the Japanese are the same. Paddington Hospital, Paddington, something like that, the same.
Buckingham Palace.
That's it, yeah.
I was watching this programme, I don't know if it might not be your cup of tea, The Real Exotic Marigold.
I've seen parts of that, yeah.
Oh, it's brilliant. And it's these four pensioners, and they're famous people. There's the darts player. There's that little fat lady who's wonderful. She was in Harry Potter. She was a witch,
right.
a good witch, I think. There's another lady, tall, stout lady, who does cooking, and the dancer Wayne Sleep. And they go to other countries to see what it would be like to live there as a pensioner. And funnily enough, they were in Florida.
Oh, okay.
And honestly, they went, they're kind of retirement homes. But nothing like the retirement homes here. I mean, I dread the day if I ever have to go into one of those. They're horrendous here. But there, they've all got like their own little houses in like a massive gated community. And they did these two places in Florida, one which was affordable. And the houses there were like £150,000. Yeah, no, dollars. $150,000. So £130,000, which is affordable. And then at the other end of the spectrum, they went in this other one, and the cheapest one was $2.5 million. Whoa. And in that one, and it goes, and they all have all these lavish dinners and activities and pristine grass. And, oh, it's beautiful, beautiful, and it's all gated, and they got a security man on the door. You go in and out, but everyone seems to be happy. But they've all had bloody facelifts. And they all look...
And Botox and that sort of stuff.
It all looks really very strange. They don't look normal, most of them. Although I will say there was one lady who was, I think, 72 years old. Well, you couldn't tell that she'd had a facelift and she looked about 28.
Blimey.
So I'm going to find out who that surgeon was and go to them, I think, Matt.
Oh, you can do that when you retire, is it? Get a bit of Botox facelift.
No, I don't think so. I mean, they just look dreadful. People have had all this stuff done, I think. Absolutely. Maybe, yeah. Would you do that as you get older?
No. Hopefully I'm their age gracefully, so.
Yeah, I think so. Me too.
Yeah, we don't look our age, do we? So.
I don't think so, Matt. No, you still look about 28, mate. Don't worry about it. 25, okay?
25, yeah.
That's lovely right, to talk to you, Matt. Thanks ever so much for calling in. Enjoy your holiday, all right?
Yeah, and enjoy your show. I'll keep watching your show.
Thank you. Cheerio. Bye-bye now. Bye now. There's young Matt there. Gosh. Oh, it's so long since I spoke to some of these people today. back to some of these messages. John says, oh no, we've done that one. Zach says, when are your mugs being released? They are now being made. Okay, I'm having 20 done. I'm having 20 mugs done to start with. I'm going to pick those up. I'm going to pick those up at the end of February, but we might be able to get hold of them before that. Okay, what I could do is it's my sister who's making them all. She makes mugs and T-shirts and all those sort of things. So what I might do is, if you want one, send me your, not now, don't send me any addresses now, but and certainly not in public. You have to do it as a private message or an email. And then I can give her the, and she could send them perhaps direct from them. So the mugs are being done now. Do not worry, be just a couple of weeks. That is all sorted now, okay? I won't tell you what the picture is. That can be a little bit of excitement. It'd be like Christmas all over again for you, won't it? Waiting for your United Kingdom talk mug. How strange that is. Back to the phones. Adam the plumber's on the line. Hello, Adam. How are you?
Good evening. Is that Mr. Chris Reardon, international DJ, award winner of 94, 95, 96? Boys,
thank you very much, darling. That is me, international television personality Chris Reardon is speaking to you at the moment. How does that make you feel?
I am so honoured. I am so honoured and committed.
I thought so. I thought
at least
so.
I should be committed.
How's life with you today, Adam?
Yeah, not too bad. I'm just on my way to church, so I'm phoning up to have a grumble, actually.
Oh, yes?
You're on too early. I'm going to miss half the show, dear.
Oh, well, you can always watch the recording later on,
I
dear.
I can watch on replay, can't I?
You can watch it on the United Kingdom Talk player.
That's it, yes, dear.
Well, that is Facebook or YouTube, to be honest, but I like to make names of these sort of things. So you're in a spiritualist church, aren't you, you go to?
I am indeed, yes.
And what time is your mat? Is a mass or service? What do you call it? A service?
It's what's known as a Divine Sunday service. It starts at 6:30.
And what time is that? 6:30, is it?
6:30 to 8. Yes, you should come along one evening.
I will have to come along one evening. Yeah. Do you get to talk to people that have gone?
Yes, you do, yes. Oh. If a medium should happen to come to you, they will give you a message.
Oh, okay.
From a loved one or a friend or a family member.
Yes. I'm very open to that sort of thing, as you well know.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, talking of little things that have died, my sister's lost a dog tonight.
Oh, dear.
Oh, yeah. Her name was Dutchess, and she was a black Labrador. Such a lovely dog. A few years ago, when I was a little bit ill, I had very bad flu-like symptoms and was permanently tired. Yeah, before I went into the doctor and found out what it was. So I was in this, and I was at her house on the Christmas, and I was permanently tired, and I laid on this settee, right? And I'm not joking, this dog came up to me, sniffed around, and then jumped up onto the settee and laid on top of me to give me comfort. Yeah. They know, don't they, when pets are ill?
Oh, definitely. Pets definitely know when you're ill. I mean, you sometimes see on Facebook and places like that where they, you know, somebody who's sort of close to passing over, and the last thing they do is sort of want a cuddle from their pet or whatever, and you just see the animal laid out on the bed next to them, giving them that bit of comfort, and it's lovely. Yeah. I think it's something that should be introduced into care homes and
pets. Oh, absolutely, yeah. Cats as well, actually. I think I saw a little item about someone's sending a load of love hearts. Mm. That's very kind of you. A cat that was in a care home, and that would lay on someone. But the trouble is, they knew when the cat went to the room and wouldn't leave, they knew that that person was about to go. You know, so a bit worrying if that cat suddenly appears at your door, isn't it?
Keep an eye on Katie there, dear. Keep an eye on Katie.
Oh, she don't come anywhere. I think she's. I have a feeling she's going blind.
Oh, bless
Katie, her. Katie, yeah. I have a feeling she's going blind because I put the food down and she's meowing and waiting for the food. I'm like, it's down there. And what I have to do is get my finger and make her see right up to her face, make her see the finger go down to the food, and then she comes down to the bottom of the finger and finds the food. I'm not sure if she's going blind or not. I think a little trip to the vets. And she does make lots of noises. And I don't know what sort of noises, if she's in pain or anything like that. And, you know, last night I was watching her.
Mm-hmm.
And she keeps going round and round in circles. And and she was moaning. And I thought, I think this might be being a bit cruel now. Mm. You know, not taking her down the vet, worried that what they might say.
Yeah, what the outcome might be. Yeah, of course,
it might.
Yeah.
And I did have a cat once called Tiny. I don't know if you remember Tiny the cat.
Mm-hmm.
I knew she was ill, and I wouldn't take her to the vet, and she kept weeing her bed. I mean, it wouldn't just be damp. I mean, it wouldn't just be damp, Adam. You could pick the bed up, and the water would pour out of it. It weren't just damp; it would pour out of it anyway. And I kept, you know, obviously, I think I bought another one in the end, and I just kept washing them. But it was happening all the time. You know, the moment one had dried, you'd have to change it over again. And then one morning, and she just sat in the bed all the time. She didn't do anything else. She just sat in the bed all the time. And then one morning I woke up and she was on the kitchen floor, on her side, quivering.
Oh, dear.
Like that. And I thought, oh, my God. And it was a Sunday and it was 12 o'clock. So I rung up the vet.
Mm.
And, okay, you can bring her straight in. I said, okay, thank you very much. And then they started going on about because it's a Sunday, it's so-and-so, plus the vet's at lunch at the moment, so I'll have to come sort it be this next. I said, that's fine, dear. Honestly, getting their bloody money in first, but nevertheless.
Oh, yeah, so, I know. I mean, I know a friend that's just had a horrendous vet bill for emergency care of a cat.
Yes.
You know, I won't say how much it is or who it is, but they had a horrendous cat bill.
How much?
Bill. Well, I'll tell you how much it was.
Yeah.
It was near on £1,000.
Gosh.
For emergency pet care.
Yeah, that's a lot of money, isn't it?
You know, but obviously, you know, the cat is loved and you do anything for the animal.
Oh, right? Yes. Yes, absolutely. I had quite a high, it wasn't as high as that. I had a higher bill a few years ago, I remember now, and I actually didn't go up to my sister's at Christmas because I let her go and I didn't want to leave her on her own.
Yeah, I was watching the show on that the other day.
Oh, you remember that, do you? Gosh.
Yeah.
You're watching it? I was watching an old...
What I do when I'm at work and I want some... I don't have the radio on, I normally put one of your shows on.
Right, okay.
And have it going in the van. And
Don't have it on in a van, dear. People have fallen asleep driving while they're... While they're listening to one of my shows.
Let me see. It was December the... Hold on. It was December the 21st, 2014, that was.
It was 2000 and what?
December the 21st, I think it was, around 2014.
14, 15, 16. Oh, it's 2 years ago. Oh, no, it's three.
Yeah,
that would be three, wouldn't it?
I can't quite remember. I think it was either... It might be 13 or 14, but basically you were worried about she wasn't feeling too well. Going up to the city, basically.
Well, I remember that. And anyway, so Tiny the cat, going back to that now. So I immediately picked her up in the bed and took her down the vet. And I have to say, as I got to the vet, right, as I opened the door with a cat in my arm, with a bed in my arms, the people immediately left. I heard a shout and the people behind the desk immediately came in front of the desk, come to the front door. Okay, we'll take her from you now. You just sit there and wait and we'll have a look at her. They came and it was excellent, excellent service. And so I sat there and waited for a little while. And then they came and, if you'd like to go into the room now, Mr. Reardon, thank you very much. And I went into the room and the cat's in there. And they told me that, she's now very dehydrated. We can try and rehydrate her and try and find out what's wrong, but she will suffer while we're trying to do that. What do you want to do? And I said, okay, time for her to go to sleep then, you know. Yeah. And I managed to get one more photo with her in my arms.
Mm.
And then that was it. And then that's the last I saw from her.
Exactly, but the cats are always around you, even when they're passed. You know.
Oh yes, but you know the bills don't end there. Oh, no. No, if you... No. So you get them cremated. If you want the ashes back, that's another 100 quid, dear. I mean, how much does it cost to burn a body, for Christ's sake?
Exactly.
I've already started building a fire in my garden for mine.
I actually had a friend of mine that had a cat that died.
Yes.
And
will you stop waving that phone around, dear? Speak into the microphone.
Sorry, dear. There you go. And anyway, I had this friend...
Where have you gone?
I'm here, dear. I'm here.
You've moved the microphone in front of your mouth, dear.
All right, dear. There we go,
That's
dear.
It. How perfect. About, perfect.
Anyway, so I had this a friend of mine that had this cat that passed away, and that was about 2 weeks after his mother had passed away. The cat passed away afterwards. So he had the ashes of the cat put in with the mother.
Oh, right. Okay.
Because I think it was the mother's cat, if I remember rightly. So, they, you know, he had them sort of put together, as it were. So I think that was rather sweet.
Oh, that'd be very interesting. You know, if you believe in, like, the reincarnation or anything like that. You know, because, you know, once we turn to dust and we all get mixed up again, maybe that will come back as part human, part cat.
You never know, there's a cat woman. did you see the little video link I sent you of the Hoover?
Was that you who sent me that?
The one with the cat on it.
Oh, no, I haven't seen that yet, Adam. Was that a private message? Oh, hang on a minute, my mouse has failed. I keep losing my mouse. There it is. Eh?
Dying mouse as well now. Oh dear, we are doing well.
I'll have a little look for that later on, dear.
Yes, do have a look at that, because that could be a, let me put it like this, it could be a Katie mode of transport.
A Katie mode of transport, now that she doesn't walk around much anymore.
Yes, exactly.
Lovely for you to call in. Have a lovely service this evening.
Thank you, Mr. Redden. Goodbye.
Cheerio, Adam. There we are. Adam the plumber there. Looks after all your plumbing needs. If you've got a toilet that's blocked up, he's only too happy to roll up his sleeve and go down that U-bend and sort it all out for your boys and girls, OK? Back to some of these messages. Hello to Anne this evening. Good evening, Anne. Hope you're feeling better, Anne. I know you weren't well for a while, my darling. let's have a look. Martin says I'm lazy. Who's lazy? I can't be. How can I be lazy? How could anyone ever say I'm lazy? I'm just working non-stop, working non-stop. Anne says it was £550 to cremate her horse a few years ago. Oh my God, Anne. Oh my God. Have you got a sense of humour, Anne? I just want to say something. Have you got a sense of humour? I'm sure you have. I mean, it would have been cheaper to send it to Findus, wouldn't it, dear? That's what. I hope you follow. I hope you're not offended by that. I'm really offended. Oh, don't take it lightly. The horse would laugh. I know the horse would laugh, Anne. All right. Hello to Tommy Flynn this evening. Anne also says £1,000 when her dog Manilow broke his leg, and that was 12 years ago. That how did the dog break its leg? Did it get run over? Pets are very good at getting run over, aren't they? Fortunately, where I am, there's not a road here. John says, I had the same with my Jack Russell. It was the hardest thing to do, but we don't like seeing our pets suffer. No, we don't. And I think, you know, I think it is kind of sometimes you don't want that pet to suffer. And unlike humans, you see, when a pet is suffering, it doesn't know why. And that must be even worse for it. You know, at least if you know you've got, I don't know, a bad leg or something, you know, you've run your leg over or something, like, at least you know why, don't you? Kiki D says, sometimes my cat stares at me, really worried looking, and I think, oh, maybe there's something wrong with me and the cat knows. Well, yes, you could be right, Kiki D. You don't know, darling. Phone lines are still open if you want to call in tonight, 020-8144-3477. Hello to Callum, who's joining us tonight. Diane, who's half of Heart and Soul. Now, which half are you, Diane? Heart and Soul is like a duo, male and female singer. So are you Heart or are you Soul? That's the question, Diane. Which are you? I think you're more Heart. I think you're Heart. Or you might be Soul. Which one are you, Heart or Soul? Thank you, Kevin, for your kind comments there. Stacey says, my cat has fleas, Chris. Had mum to get special cat tablets. Oh, yeah, you can get tablets as well to get rid of fleas and that sort of thing, can't you, as well? Yeah, I remember that. Hello to Ashley as well. Ashley's with us. And good evening. Who's calling in now, please?
It's Anne.
Hello, Anne. All right, Auntie.
I'm fine, thank you.
Auntie. Auntie has got a Barry Manilow grotto. Just like you might have a little Jesus and Mary grotto. Anne has a Barry Manilow. Is there any pictures of your grotto?
Yeah, I've got some on my Facebook page.
Oh, I haven't looked at that. I must
but
have
I'm
a little look.
I'm packing it all up at the moment.
Oh, why is that then?
Because I'm going to be evicted.
Oh. Have you got somewhere else to go yet?
No.
Oh, my God. When's that then?
My car, most probably.
The car?
Yeah.
Oh, you want to get a van? You know, like that film.
Yeah, I could put a mattress in that, couldn't I?
Yeah, you know, like that. Have you seen that film, the lady in the van, or something like that, with Dame Maggie Smith?
Oh yes, yeah. She walked outside somebody's house, didn't she?
Oh, that's a wonderful film that was on at Christmas. I've got that on my video recorder. I've been watching, and she paints the van bright yellow.
Oh yeah.
I thought you'd gone then for a moment. There was a moment of silence. Well, you were considering then, weren't you, whether to paint your car yellow or not?
No, I was just thinking about my pink bench that I've got outside.
A pink bench? Oh, my Lord. Anyway, Anne, what you got to chat about today, my darling?
No, it was just when you were talking about the pets and everything, about how expensive it all is and whatever. So, just to say that Manilow was run over, bless him.
Oh, he was he? Bless his heart.
Yeah, 2 years old he was.
I take it you didn't have the pet insurance?
No, I don't bother because they after they've had an injury, they take it out of the policy.
Oh, do they really?
Yeah, so you end up paying for something. And like, if he hurt his leg again for something different, they wouldn't actually pay out.
Well, I must say, I've never had cat pet insurance. Well, it's just pet insurance. What was that noise?
Oh, that's my dog.
What did it do? Was it sneezing?
No, he barks.
I thought it was a sneeze. I thought it was some. I thought go. Rachel was in the house sneezing her head off then for a minute.
I only get like a 2 minute phone call. Wendy calls him Sir Barkalot.
Sir Barkalot.
I won't tell you what Rachel calls him.
What?
The little effer.
Oh no, we mustn't use that word on this clean family programme, my
That's
dear.
That's why I said effer.
Good Lord. Anyway, so I've never had the pet insurance, and even with the money I spent out on my cat over the last few years, I don't think I would have spent that on insurance premiums, you know?
No, it's a waste of money.
Yeah, I got that the wrong way around. If I had insurance premiums, I would have spent more than the few times that I've been to the vet. Of course, it's all a bit of a... a lottery, really, isn't it? To see which ones get ill and which ones don't.
Yeah, I mean, most of the minor ailments you can treat yourself. I mean, I worked with horses for years, so I can treat most things myself.
Oh, right,
like if it's a cut or whatever, I can just treat that. But it's only when it's major. I mean, Manny had an operation on his eyelid because he had a lump.
Oh, right, yeah.
But that was quite reasonable. That was only about a couple of hundred pounds to have that removed.
Reasonable. Couple of hundred pounds, reasonable, dear.
Well, he had an operation, so.
Right, yeah. So oh, I know. But I must, I've got to take my cat to the vet and see if we've got a little bit of a problem there. A little thing is growing on her chin, which is getting bigger now. But we'll do what we can. Have you got any pets at the moment, Anne?
Yeah, I've got my dog, Manilow.
Manilow the dog. Does it sing Barry Manilow tunes, please?
No, he howls.
Oh, does he?
Yes, and shouts along. he doesn't usually do it in tune.
Probably sounds better than some of those people I've been sitting to singing at the concerts, dear.
Oh my word,
dear me. Were you at that concert, the Barry Manilow concert, when there was a woman in the front row who stood up while Barry was talking and she would be shouting back to him like she thought she was having some sort of conversation with
him? Oh, that happens all the time.
I can't believe it. But they don't chuck them out, do they?
No, but then you should go to a concert in America because they sit there like they're sucking lemons.
Oh, I have.
You get like the hardcore fans which join in, but when you're surrounded like with loads of people that just sit there?
In particular, the problem was in New York at the St. James's Theatre. I went there for my 50th birthday, particularly to see him. That's why I went, really. And then I thought, well, if I'm going to see him, I might as well have a couple of days either side of it as well. Which, actually, it was so cold. I wish I'd just gone there, seen the show and come back again. That's how cold it was. And I was very aware of that. And people were just sitting down. They just sat down. And I'm not saying they didn't enjoy it. I'm sure they did. But I thought, why isn't any... And there were some people standing up dancing. Guess what flags they had flying?
They had the Union flag.
Yes, exactly.
Though,
they had the Union flag with them. And they had those sort of, you know, draped around their shoulders and all that. They were all up and dancing, but the American ladies didn't dance. How disappointing.
In fact,
while the dancing people were near me and one of them got tapped on the shoulder, excuse me, could you sit down? We can't see the show. Oh, some people are no fun at all, are they, Anne?
I know.
Well, my love, I hope you get your housing sorted out, darling, all right?
I hope so too.
Thank you very much for calling in. Lovely Auntie.
Take care.
Lots of love to you. Bye-bye, darling.
All right, bye.
There we are. Anne has got she is a massive Manilow fan, a much bigger Manilow fan than I consider myself a big fan. But these are fans of the highest degree. Yes, they are. Tony Power wants to know where his commission is. Commission for what, dear? What have I got to give you commission for? We can't be a fault. What am I giving you? What do you want commission for? Please let me know. Dear me, commission. Oh, what's the time? Oh, is it 6 o'clock? Oh, okay. Well, we're disappearing shortly then. Elaine says, hello, Chris. Feeling a bit sick today, but I'm happy to be here with you. We're happy to see you, Elaine. Thank you very much, darling. Shania says, we are still not home. Later than expected. Oh, gosh. Dear me, it's about time. That time you lot went home sitting in that pub all night long. It's not good for you. We got a couple of messages here to read out, boys and girls. Let me just get back to those. There we are. Hello to... Oh, and the birthdays are coming up as well. If it's your birthday, that's coming up shortly as well. Hello to Joanna, who says, I loved your beautiful blue shirt the other day. I have two fireplaces, one on main living area and one in the basement. We're talking about log fireplaces. It must be lovely to have one. I mean, this house is warm. I've got radiators, but not a log fireplace. One in the basement and one in the living area, she says, where I spend a lot of time on the computer and washing and ironing clothes, or rather you than me. Oh, I hate all that. I have a lady who does my ironing, actually. I love my logs burning. The colours are beautiful. I can go into a trance watching the fire. Yes, you can. You totally can. It's beautiful to have a log fire, isn't it? Joanna also says, I also agree with you. There is only one megastar, Barry Manilow. So you are my international superstar. See, I'm international, dear. We're not local radio here. Not local, international, dear, international. Love your show and thanks for the beautiful start. Yes, we were giving away this the other day. See, you missed out. You probably missed the show. I was giving away my Christmas star, which will still illuminate, I think. Nope, that won't illuminate anymore. Batteries are dead. Batteries, I think that said it. And then just a minute. Nope, that's it now. That will illuminate on the insertion of a new set of batteries. And I said, does anyone want it? And actually, Joanna was the only person who wanted it. So she sent me through her address and I shall be sending it off to her. And her address is number... Not really. Oh, I'm so awful sometimes. Joanna also says, I loved your opening the other day. Loved the singing. Was that Chitty Chitty Bang Bang I was singing? I think it was. Oh, I can't believe no one wanted your beautiful star. So I'm very excited to receive it. Yes, that'll be in the post. What's the day? What's today? Is it Saturday? I can't remember now. Oh, it's Sunday today. It's Sunday today. So I'll probably box that up and I've got a box here, actually. There's a box. I can put this in the box. Now, be warned. It might be a bit sparkly, okay? You might get sparkle all over your carpet, I'm afraid. Look, I'm going to put this in the box now. I'm going to place this in the box. I'll take the batteries out as well. Because you don't want... Otherwise, they might start leaking, mightn't they, if they're dead. One minute. Just a minute now. Get those batteries out of there. As funny, actually, with all the phone calls coming in. Anyone else want to call in? If you want to call in, do it quickly before we disappear. Otherwise, I'll disappear now, OK? If anyone wants a quick chat, call in. 020-8144-3477 is the number. Right, we've got the batteries out. So I'll try and make sure I can send that off tomorrow for you, my darling. All right. What are we doing now? Birthdays, isn't it? Birthdays now. Or messages. Should we do messages first? Messages or birthdays? Ah, there we are. Birthdays. Okay. 1 second, my darlings. Birthdays. Come on, where's your birthdays? There we are. Happy birthday. Ah, look, lots of people I know today. Here come the birthdays. There's 11 birthdays today. So Stephen Derek Hill, who drives a bus. And Stephen always used to come to the Belushi's Karaoke in London Bridge. Now, you often hear me say that. I'm really surprised at how many of our old Belushi's friends come up on the Facebook with their birthdays. And it's always so nice to see you. It really is those wonderful, wonderful times that we had at Belushi's London Bridge a few years ago. It's about two or three years ago now. I loved that job. It was damn hard work, I tell you. It was a blooming hard job to work because everyone was so drunk. But I loved it. I absolutely loved that job. So happy birthday to you today, Stephen, 32 years old today. Happy birthday to Kevin Melville, to Dan Ellis. Haven't seen you for a while, Dan. I think you're the Dan who used to come in 286 in Lewisham, aren't you? Happy birthday, Dan. Bill Buckley, international radio show host extraordinaire. He's been on That's Life. You remember That's Life? Sausages, sausages. That was the dog, wasn't it? He used to say sausages. Bill's 58 tonight. He's done a lot of work for the BBC. Happy birthday, Bill. Okay. Happy birthday to Alan Audrain. To Suko Sullivan, old Suko in New York. How are you, darling? Happy birthday to my lovely, lovely friend Suko. I haven't spoke to you for a long, long time. I must give you a ring sometime, Suko. Suko used to do a little radio show on United Kingdom Radio. It was a little talk station that I used to run. It was very, very, an awful lot of work, that is. So I gave it up in the end. But Suko did a little show there. And she used to do inserts for Thameside Radio as well, where she did bits and pieces. Happy birthday, Suko. Happy birthday to Danny TC. Danny TC, happy birthday, sir. To Gavin Kinseng Lim, 39 today. Happy birthday, Gavin. Jerka Zadomka, 42 today. To Michael Black, 31 today. To DJ Paul Heron. Hello, Paul. Look, I'm doing this now, dear, from DJing to television show personality extraordinaire host. That's what I'm doing. Hello, Paul. Happy birthday, Paul. And happy birthday to the fittest man I know. He does fitness and he teaches people fitness things and all that. Terry Walpole. Walpole, who I worked with many, many years ago at a little place in Chiswick. Happy birthday as well to you, Terry. It's been so long since I've seen some of these people. It really is. But it's lovely that I'm able to wish you happy birthday. Here we go. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, happy birthday, happy birthday to you. All right? I know it's towards the end of the day, but I'm sure you'll enjoy the rest of your birthdays. That's it on the show today. Now, I've got a very small piece of apple pie downstairs, which I'm going to enjoy now with a cup of tea. I did have my dinner just before I came up to see you because I've had a bit of a day, really. I didn't sleep well at all last night. After I finished the show, I went downstairs. I was going to go for a walk, but I didn't. I went walking on the spot for about 20 minutes while watching the end of Casualty. And after that, I went to bed and I just couldn't sleep last night. I don't know why. And this often happens if I've got a night off. I've noticed that. If I've got a night off, I don't sleep very well. So tonight, I shall absolutely go out and have a walk. But this morning I got up and I was very tired. I got up for church. And I went to church, and it wasn't really raining. It felt like, you know, it was a bit foggy, and that was the mist coming off. Anyway, I went to church, and funny enough, in church, there's a bit in church where the altar server rings bells. There was two little boys sitting behind me, and every time he rang the bell, they said in a loud voice, "Ding dong, ding dong." Oh, they were funny. They did make me laugh. Anyway, I came out of church, and it was pouring down with rain, and I didn't have any wet trousers, you know, plastic trousers. I had the wet top up there, so that was okay, and it's got a hood, so I didn't get wet on the top. But my legs got absolutely soaking wet. I mean, absolutely soaking wet my legs got. And I got home, and I took off the trousers quickly, and dried them off with a towel, and I put my dressing gown on. I thought, well, I'll have a shower. I fancy having a shower now. And I sat down, and I had two bits of toast and a cup of tea, and then I became incredibly tired. This is like 11 o'clock in the morning. Incredibly tired, because I go to church on a Sunday, I have to get up about 7:30, and I leave the house at 8:20, and I cycle too there, cycle back soaking wet. I got really tired. And I went to bed just after the toast at about 11:45 this afternoon, actually. And I woke up again. I kind of was drifting in and out of sleep. And I woke up again at about 4:00. And then I went downstairs and had lunch. So I'm all a bit all over the place today with my time. And I can only think it must have been the rain that had come down and made me cold and made me incredibly tired. Had something to eat and then came back here and spoke to you for an hour and 20 minutes or so, haven't we? So quite a nice day all in all. Anyway, I'll disappear now. Thanks very much for watching and listening this evening, boys and girls. Another show for you very soon. Don't forget, you can always send an email in if you want to. chris@unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk is my email address. chris@unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. Enjoy your Sunday evening. I'll see you soon. Cheerio.